doesn't want me doing this, because most people expect, oh, he's trying to set head and arm. Okay? So what's likely going to happen here is he'll take his arm over my head. Give me that. Okay? So what I'm going to do now is I put this in and I clamp. What I'm waiting for here now is Rob trying to get his hand back under my head. So as he does, I took my head in. So you see how his arm's come part way under? Get the grip. Now, I've seen this thousands of times. People grab this here and think, oh, I've got it. And they do this and they wonder why the guy's not tapping. So get this, take it out. 90 degree. Shoulder, shoulder, wrist. Okay? That's all it means. If you've got flexible arms, you get to there. So MMA, bang with the elbow and pop the shoulder through at the same time. Well, one after the other. Yeah? But it's the way that, again, the way I'm playing this arm. Right? So, he's got the arm in, I want rid of that. So I want him to feel, again, for the guys who are a little bit more advanced, watch what I do here. I'm not making this a muscle effort. Look, basically do is I put my elbow on his hip. I get that as far as I can go. Then I start putting my head in on it. He doesn't want it trapping, so it goes in, which is, thank you very much. Okay? So as we're in this position, I just alter my weight, sit my hips in him a bit more, and as that arm comes, I drop my arm to his bicep. Okay? Now all they're thinking is, stop him coming under my head. That's his arm trapped. Yeah? The only danger I've got to worry about really is, when I go to do this, it takes his hand back. Right, he's not going to give me that again. Okay, we'll go around to this one again, which we've already done. So, let's go back to a different option. Stay. In. Up. Pops it around. That's fine. Okay, as he goes to bring it around, just drop my hand. As you get more experience, you really feel for where their arm is. No thumbs. May I extend? If I've got to bring it back down, I will. So even if the person's armed out, we used to do a drill where the person had their arm out and you've got to try and isolate it. So, looking for a Kimura from here, he's moving his arm around, so I'm trying to... You're going to struggle, it's good. And what eventually happens, if I was underneath, what I'm hoping for is that bit by bit you'll start to reach over. Because once you start to do that, your weight's not on me the same, I can start to create direction. I can create direction, I can create movement and so on. Okay? So what I'll be looking at here, if Rob's arm was out, okay, I'd start here. So he can move his arm around all he wants. Just track it. Don't try and catch it while it's flying around. Track it from the base, throw it out. Okay? Same as when. You might be able to get this one. I've leaned on him here. Person at the side of your face. I lean into it, using my shoulders to pin. Elbow comes in the side of his head. Back. Again, look at the position. Wrist, shoulder, shoulder. Pretty much aligned. If it's above it, you get some real flexible shoulders, you don't tap them. Especially when you're looking at doing it now from half guard or from max. You need that angle. The other thing that people can do from there is he recognises I want that, so he turns his hand the other way. Okay? Underneath that way. Same thing, I use my chin this time. To pin. Grab his wrist. Come up. Drop the hip. Step over the head. And I'm looking for that 90 degrees. Again, elbow, shoulder, shoulder. Okay? Wrist, shoulder, shoulder that way, elbow, shoulder, shoulder that way. So, see how I'm literally, remember when you were a kid and your mum used to say, oh, for God's sake, use your head. Now I know what my mum and dad meant. And I'm doing it. Okay? So as the arm goes out, no matter where it is, even in this position, Bob's moving his arm around and I'm waiting to feel that position.
I'll even do this, sandwich it between my arm and my head. But when Rob moves his arm around, I'm still tracking. I feel it come. I feel, because as soon as I've got my head on in here, I can feel his bicep popping underneath my head. So without seeing it, I can feel which way it is. Okay? So then if it goes the other way, and if it's alright, go down that way. Okay, look, my head's on it, I'm pinning it. Because once I've got his wrist, look, snatch, pull the elbow in. Feel for that. Okay. Step over. Don't let him sit up, pin his head down. Unless you can let him sit up if you want to look for fishing a triangle through. Okay, and then finally, if your partner, you do this and they go, ah, got my belt. Okay? So those that enjoyed the brutal one earlier on, you'll like this one. I lift him, look, between my elbow through. My elbow by his wrist, hand on my bicep. These are things I've been taught when I've trained with Eric Wilson. Really effective. That one, last one's horrible. So, as he goes down, I've got this hand underneath and he's gripped his belt. I mean, I can play it and trap his head, try to come round him, trap the head and start looking for the camorra off it. Okay? And from here, I'll lift him to get my elbow in. See where I put my elbow under his arm? And I'll shove that over because I don't want him letting go. If he does, we're back into the tracking him with my head and I'll look for the other one. Elbow on the floor, hand on my bicep. I step over his head. I just elevate. If you want to feel that, give me a shout and I'll show you. It's not pleasant. So have a go with just one bit of that, because of what time we've got. So just have a go at one bit. Pick one that you like the look of and have a try of that, please.
Yeah, that's one.